Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a Mega Bloks Collector Series Call of Duty set review. This is set number 6818. Comes with 527 pieces, and in the United States it costs $50 even. So obviously this is a play set. This is not just a set that revolves around one specific thing, so we've got a lot of stuff to look at. I'm gonna get right into looking at the main thing itself, the main structure. So let's move all this other stuff away and look at just that. Sometimes things in construction sets are a little bit abstract, or they're inspired by something, but they're not really replicating it. In this case, we have a direct corollary between the actual game, Modern Warfare 3 in this case, and the set, because there actually is a map there called Dome, and that's what this is based on. You've got a big derelict radar dome, I guess it's called for short, and a structure that's in support of that, and it's in a desert biome, a desert kind of area, so that explains why you have this sort of desert camo as the main color of the entire structure. So many colors go into building or creating these pieces. It's really impressive, the fact that they use little specks of darker color in there, and then there's also marbling effects. You've got the brown, you've got white, I don't know if there's a red in there also. I know there's red in the specs, but multiple colors go together, really make this thing very, very random looking. That really helps it to look less toyish, you know, especially when you consider all this is just a flat space. Imagine if that was all just solid tan, it would be very boring, but this way they're able to use just regular blocks, which you can then use with other sets, and you know, if you want to take this apart and put other things together, you can use them for all sorts of stuff. From the back, you can see it's fairly open, just a lot of open space, so you've got, you know, a little bit of cover. You can peek around corners there, peek around corner here, peek around there, kind of duck behind this barrel just a little bit. If you don't have a lot of space to really open this up when you're playing, you can close it up. It's hinged over here, and you just have this single pin which goes into a hole in the side of these, and there we go, kind of push it together with a little bit of force there. It helps it to go together more easily. It's a little bit tighter than it really needs to be, but it works out. Up on the upper level, you've got some sandbags going around the side here, and then you've got the catwalk. You've got the outer walk all the way around the edge, which again is based on what's actually in the game. And then they give you one ladder. Really should have been two ladders to defend the upper level here, but at least they kind of give you the general idea. If you have more parts, that's something I would definitely recommend as a customization. Put another ladder on the opposite side of this somewhere, just for a little more realism if you care about that. We also have a flag up here which you can use for capturing. That can be your main thing to defend, and you can see that to get to it you have to actually get up to the top level and then walk all the way around, which is kind of a good thing. I think that works out well with the fact that they only have one ladder, one way to access this, which is on the opposite side, so that's kind of good. Now the dome is the main thing, and I've been kind of avoiding that because I have a little bit of mixed feelings about this. It's a radome. If you look at the actual thing in game, or if you look at any desert based old radar domes, a lot of the time they'll be first of all they're always covered with some sort of cloth or some sort of material that's very thin that makes this kind of look like just a solid ball from the outside. You can't see through them. In game, this map does have a radome which is derelict. It's old, it's abandoned, the cloth has started to deteriorate, it hasn't been kept up. Some of these pieces are open and you can actually see inside through there. So in looking through there, you can see that there's actually the radar dish itself, the part that would normally spin, doesn't spin anymore, but the way this is constructed is kind of funny. You can see through everywhere, there's no coverage, and you can spin this outside point. It's kind of the opposite of what would happen in real life. I think that's just a matter of the pieces that were used to put it together, but I still think it looks good is the thing. It's not accurate to the game or to real life in terms of the fact that it's open, but like I said, I still think it looks good. I think it's actually a good thing to be able to see the radar dish in there. It helps, you know, especially younger kids to better understand exactly what it is, what's in there. And you know, I could go either way on either liking that or disliking it, but in all, I think that it worked out pretty well. And it's really the defining thing of this entire set is the dome itself, which makes sense. It should be. Overall, this is just a nice structure. Not too complicated, but well designed, you know, scaled down, much smaller than the thing would be if it was an exact replica of what's in game. But for the size that they did, keeping the price down, keeping the size and complexity down, I think they chose the overall features very well. And I think it works really well with the separating feature to be able to get different angles for the whole thing. Now here's your aerial drone, which is seen flying through the sky on the box art. This is it was a very interesting build. I really didn't expect it to go together the way that it did. I didn't really spend a lot of time trying to analyze it. Its design. I didn't spend any time trying to analyze its design before I put it together, but it's a very Spartan build. It's really skinny. Look at how, I mean, the wings are only two plates high. The main fuselage is one single brick wide, and the height is about 1 2/3 bricks. Given how small and thin that they made this, it goes together well. It looks good in the end, and it's functional because you've got a propeller back here, which these things do have propellers, spins, that's good. You've got an antenna here, or sensor, that's on the front that's making it look a little bit asymmetrical and just like it's got some forward sight to it, as well as this entire bulbous section in the front, which has sensors in it. And it is armed, so you've got missiles, and these can pull right off. And you got four of these. They look nice. This thing looks good. And I like the scale of it. And yeah, it's just a successful piece. Oh, hello, remote Gatling gun turret. That thing's gonna have quite a greeting if you go up against it and you're not on its side. This is great. It's a nice little build. It uses a lot of really small parts, putting them together. And it ends up looking pretty good. I especially like the stand, the quadrupedal stand or quadrupod that it's on. It has some very large barrels. You know that thing's going to be spitting out some high caliber shells. Does have the antenna, the remote antenna on there. Ammo box over here. It's a little bit of a belt guide. Doesn't go together all perfectly because the little sample ammo belt that's included is a little bit on the short side, but you know they kind of tried to pull that off pretty decently. I think it works out pretty good. I like the range of colors on this thing, and I like the thing in general. You know, just the idea of a remote Gatling gun turret, and I think that it was pretty well executed by MegaBlocks. The figures here are billed by MegaBlocks as Master Sergeant Sandman and two random other special forces dudes. They don't get names in this one, probably are based on some actual in-game characters. I'm not a player of the game, so I don't know their specific names, but I'm okay with that because I can enjoy the figures anyway. As always, of course, beautiful details on these guys and incredible, ridiculous amounts of articulation thanks to all the many, many, many different joints that are included in each. If you haven't seen my other videos, you should. I go into more detail of just all of the different points of articulation that you get in these guys. So I'm just going to give this guy a different pose. So there we go. Toughest thing dealing with the articulation with these is that you can have so many different accessories on them. Sometimes their accessories can get in the way a little bit, but I much prefer being able to do so much with them and being able to add so much on there. I'm not going to enumerate out every single accessory that's included on each of these, but you can see different colors of straps and ammo pouches and knives and grenades and all the different components of each weapon, and those are all interchangeable. They're interchangeable across the different figures in different sets. They're all compatible. You can pop and swap the forearms, the upper arms, the upper legs, the lower legs, the hips, the waist portion with the little belt in there. The vests can be removed. The heads can be removed. They're on ball joints. All pretty much the standard stuff between all of these Call of Duty figures that they've created. But in this set, I do want to call out especially the key kind of star here, Master Sergeant Sandman, because this guy is extra special in what they've done to create him. First of all, he's got the vest with the American flag on it, so that's a very, very fine, small little detail that's added on there. And then, right below that, you can see he's got a grenade here. I don't know exactly what type of grenade it is, because there are multiple types that have that exact same shape. But you can see it's two colors. It's black and silver. So that makes it a little bit extra special, because most of the time, even though they have many different colors available, most of the time they're a single color each. Similarly, his knife has a brown handle, and of course they have multiple different colors of brown, but that's one of them, and it has a silver metallic blade. So again, an extra nice accessory that's included here. Another thing that's especially cool about this figure is the helmet. So, okay, we got the head, right? Pretty decent detailing there from the front. Strap going across the chin, gold goggles and all. When you look at this from the top, you can see there are two colors here, in addition to the patch on the back of it, or sticker that's on there. That is just great. Again, really small detail. But what strikes me the most is the super subtle difference in color between this top band and the base color of the round portion of the helmet itself. The round, just kind of smooth section, is a slightly reddish color, while the more elevated sections are slightly greenish. It's just a very, very subtle little difference in there that really stands out for me, because it's a surprise to see such attention to detail. They could have easily done that all in one color and most folks wouldn't ever even notice, certainly wouldn't complain, but they really went above and beyond, and I want to celebrate that. I want to call that out as a win, because I mean, this is just a toy, but they've really put some serious effort into making this thing just way better than normal minifigures. I mean, already the system is good, but this one in particular, Master Sergeant Sandman, I think really stands out as a superb figure. As always in these Mega Bloks Call of Duty sets, in addition to getting lots of accessories that you can swap around and interchange, they give you extras on top of what's designated for the figures to begin with. So a bunch of stuff here, scope, walkie-talkie, binoculars, canteen, e-tool, handgun, extra magazine, extra suppressor, extra knife, side pack or front backpack, however you want to attach that. Claymore is what this is intended to be, even though it's a little bit out of scale, but works with the figures. Flashlight, and then the special thing for this set is the inclusion of a laptop. And this actually can fold up fully. It's actually supplied in two pieces, folds up all the way, and a figure can carry it in the hand here from the top like it's a handle. The nicest thing here, well, in addition to having little simulated vents or ports on the side, but it's got the keyboard, which is well detailed. It doesn't actually have letters and numbers on it, but you can see lots of different shapes. They didn't just go super generic. And then they include this sticker. So the sticker is actually pre-applied onto the screen to show you a little bit of a map of your combat zone, current scan from the satellites showing you exactly what's going on. So I really like that, and that's an extra special accessory here. Last but not least, you need room to store all this stuff, because you know there's some really small pieces here, and if this is the first Call of Duty set you've gotten, or if just in general you don't have places to store lots of little parts and stuff like this, they give you one. They give you a care package, silver this time. It's mostly a two-piece thing. These pieces are separate, put those on, but just basically a place to put all your extra stuff. And you know, if you take stuff off of your figures, you can store them in here. Smallest things are the the little magazines, they do not fit through the holes on the sides, I'm happy to report. And you know, it's just extra storage space, or if you want to, you can pre-designate exactly what you want to put in here and drop it onto the battlefield and use it as a proper care package. And this will easily fit inside of the dome structure too, so just a nice final little thing to keep everything together. This was one of the most highly anticipated sets from the entire first series of Call of Duty sets from Mega Bloks, and understandably so. Naturally, it's big, and everybody likes things that are big and come with a whole lot of stuff. But I am not easily impressed by size alone. I want to see quality. I want to see playability. I want to see variety. Thankfully, this set does deliver all that good stuff. First off, it's based on an actual map and location that Call of Duty players will recognize and can identify with. And they've got a lot of the good important features from that map, so the accuracy is pretty good. I think that it really should have had two ladders going up to it rather than one, just for the kind of tactical realism. But I really like the way that it opens up. You can use it in its fully open position or smaller, depending upon how much space you have to play with. This is nicely done. You know, they could have covered it up, but they didn't. And you know, I already talked about my thoughts on that. I think it works out. It looks really good. The figures, especially Sandman, the figures in this series are across the board excellent. Sandman is excellent among the excellence. I mean, really a cut above right there. Predator, great. I love vehicles. I know a lot of folks like vehicles and aircraft and stuff like that. Nice to have something like that included here. And the fact that it's an actual armed Predator and has missiles that you can actually pull off and use to shoot stuff, that's great. More great accessories. Love the laptop, love it. And I especially love the Gatling gun. That is hot. Always great to have heavy weaponry. As for value, the price, $50, the number of pieces, 527. You can kind of go either way on that, whether you feel it's a little bit expensive or it's pretty good. I'm just gonna leave that up to you. Kind of determine that based on what you think. I think that it's within the range. I could have asked for it to be a little bit cheaper, given the fact that there's just not a whole lot of detailing inside of this. I would have liked to see just more stuff on the inside, would have made me feel a little bit better. But like I said, I feel like it's in the right range of price overall. So there you go. That's my look at the Dome Battleground set. Been looking forward to this one. I know a lot of folks have. And now I've had a chance to go through it, and very happy about that. So I'm going to move on to building more stuff to bring you even more videos. So I hope that you will stay tuned, come back for more. I'm always putting up new videos, mini videos per week. I rarely go more than a day or two without putting up more videos. And if I do go longer than that, you know, I'm going to have a whole bunch of them to put out at one single time. So watch for updates here on my channel and also at JANGBRiCKS.com, where you can often see stuff before it's even published on YouTube itself. Thank you very much for watching, as always, and I hope to have a chance to talk to you again soon in the next one. Bye for now.